Hey, pro bowlers and lint rollers! Is it possible that one day we will actually run out of rhymes? Like, seriously, someone look it up. How many episodes would it take? Hey, everybody! My name is John, and welcome to ADITW, A Day in the Word, the Internet's favorite Bible study. Don't blink, folks, but January is over. We are 1/12 of the way through the year, which of course means we are 8.33% through 2019. But it also means that it is time for our study of the book of James to come to a close. But we got a great final week planned for you. Please read James chapter 5 verses 1 through 20. Yes, it's the whole chapter. So, if you've been following our study from the beginning, you better. You know that part of what the author is doing in this book is summarizing the teachings of Jesus. Kind of like a greatest hits of the great I am. And this chapter is no different. As you know from your reading, there is very little through line here, but there are plenty of amazing action items that we can take. In essence, what James does here in chapter 5 is he dives into several different areas of our spiritual lives. In verses 1 through 6, James talks about our possessions. This is essentially a remix of Jesus's "It is hard for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven" lesson. This is a reminder that our possessions, or the things of this world, are temporary. Our clothes, our cars, our grades, even our human relationships will one day fade away. But the things of God, His love, His grace, His mercy, His peace in a relationship with Him, those things are eternal. Then James moves on to talk about patience by using the metaphor of a farmer. In verses 7 through 8, James discusses how it's not the farmer's job to make the seed grow. The farmer's job is to care for the seed, to patiently wait, and then to move when the moment comes. And this is something that all of us struggle with. So often in our lives, we want to make a moment happen. We want to manufacture a dating relationship for ourselves even before we're ready for it. We want to move out of our parents' house and live on our own as quickly as possible.
Please, God.
Or we try everything we can to recreate this powerful moment with God that we had years ago so that we can feel Him again. But James reminds us here that we cannot make a moment come. We can only move when it does. It is not our job to manufacture a moment. Only God can do that. The best that we can do is to patiently wait for God to move, and when He does, move with Him. Then in verse 12, James transitions to talk about promises. Not necessarily God's promises to us, but our promises to God, to others, and to ourselves. This, again, is a teaching of Jesus repackaged. In Matthew chapter 5, verse 37, Jesus said, "Let your yes be yes, and your no be no." Essentially teaching us to be people of our word. Not that we always have to say yes, but to always follow through on the promises we make. And finally, James ends the book with a word on prayer. He reminds us that whether it's trouble, happiness, sickness, or whatever the circumstance, there is always a reason to turn to God. And he reminds us of the power of prayer. He reminds us that confession in prayer can bring about healing. He reminds us that confession in prayer can bring about forgiveness. Prayer can bring about healing. Prayer can bring about provision. Now, I know that the book of James, and especially this chapter, can sort of seem like it's all over the place. But I think the thing that I take away most from this chapter and this whole book is that God wants to do a work in our lives through Jesus. Whether it's changing the way that you look at trials or pain in your life, or challenging you to be more active in your faith, or more discerning with your words. Maybe it's changing your relationship with the ways of the world and committing yourself to the ways of God. Maybe it's your possessions, patience, promises, your prayer life. I don't pretend to know what exactly it is for you, but I do know that for each and every one of us, God has a work that He wants to do in our lives. I can tell you right now, for me, It is patience. In building my own ministry, I have all of these goals and hopes and dreams for where I want this ministry to go, where I want this channel to go. And so often I find myself trying to control everything, trying to manufacture the results that I want. And then of course, when the result or the moment that I wanted doesn't come, I lash out in anger. I lash out in anger at Sweet Bear or at God. And so this year, I have actually chosen patience as my word for the year. This is the work that I believe that God wants to do in my life and in my heart this year, to grow me in patience. And I'd love to hear what it is for you. Hey friends, thank you so much for watching. I wanted to take a quick second before you go to let you know that today's show is brought to you by Audible. Why Audible? Because Audible content includes an unmatched selection of audiobooks, original audio shows, news, comedy, and more from the leading audiobook publishers, broadcasters, and entertainers. For me, I used to read a ton of fiction when I was growing up, and thanks to audiobooks, I've gotten back into fiction, whether it's on long runs or whether it's on road trips. In fact, Sweet Bear and I, we just did a giant road trip down to South Carolina and back, and each way we listened to a Lisa Jewell audiobook. If you're into suspense novels, I highly recommend Lisa Jewell. But of course, with your free trial, you can choose whatever book you want, and your first book is free. That's right, Audible is offering viewers of this show a free trial and a free book with that free trial. All you have to do is go to audibletrial.com/Jorgensen and you can sign up, get your free book, and you can start listening today. Once again, that's audibletrial.com/Jorgensen. Also, as always, I want to give a big thank you and shout out to our supporters on Patreon. If you are interested in helping support this ministry, this channel, in a financial way, for as little as $1 a month, you can simply visit the Patreon link in the description down below. That's all I have for you guys. I love you all. Keep being awesome.